Hey everybody, how's it going? Today, let's take a detailed look at the 2013 Kia Soul. And some of you may be wondering right off the bat why there's an exclamation mark in the vehicle's name in the video title. Well, that's actually the model designation. There's really no other way to describe it except the Soul actually comes in three different trim levels: base, plus, and then the exclamation mark is the top line trim. And this is going to be a detailed, in-depth view of the Soul. We'll start it up, show the engine, get an exhaust clip and go over the performance data, take it on a brief test drive, and show you a bunch of the unique aspects of the interior as well as exterior. And so, without further ado, let's go ahead and start her up, let her run. The top trim level Soul comes with an integrated smart key access system. All you have to do is keep the key fob in your pocket, and utilizing the little button on the driver's door and the passenger door, you're able to lock and unlock the vehicle. Just tap it once. One beep indicates locking. Two beeps indicate unlocking. The exterior color is a light green metallic known as Alien, and features a unique two-tone black and sand leather interior. And with that smart key system, it also has remote push-button ignition. All you have to do is put your foot on the brake, hit the button to start. Simple as that. The Soul comes standard with electric assist, speed proportional rack and pinion power steering, and a very unique 4-spoke leather-wrapped steering wheel in this particular model. Also, a color-keyed airbag center depending on which color interior scheme you go with, and a modest bit of satin gray accenting coming across the multifunction controls and a little bit of bright work. As far as the transmissions, there's two different ones available depending on the trim level. This particular one comes with the optional 6-speed automatic gearbox with manual shiftability down below. Or, you can also opt for a 6-speed manual gearbox. And active eco management. Basically what that is, activating it via this little button up here, it'll gear the transmission a little bit differently to shift quicker at lower RPMs, thus decreasing some of the thirst for fuel. It feels like it limits the performance just a little bit just because the transmission is trying so hard to shift quicker and keep the RPMs low. Therefore, for zippy, peppy maneuverability through the city and especially passing on the highway, I probably wouldn't recommend keeping that in all of the time. But if you're just putting around, just cruising around, then it's perfect for saving just a little bit of extra fuel. Put the vehicle in reverse, and a little backup camera appears, also with guidance lines. And like I said, nicely accented in soft leather and a little bright work across the center stack. And so, we're going to flip on the automatic headlamps, fog lamps, as well as the hazards. Automatic down, driver's window. And we're going to check out the exterior, shall we? The vehicle will also chime, letting you know it's lost detection of the proximity key fob. For 2013, the Kia Soul receives its first slight refresh since its introduction in 2010. Changes include new LED accent and projector beam headlamps and LED tail lamps, power folding mirrors, revised interior electronics, and a few other goodies. All put together, it gives the Soul a more upscale appearance and keeps it right on par with modern design elements. The Soul is that type of unconventional vehicle that continuously spurs curiosity. We're very familiar with this type of vehicle class, the economy-minded wagons, first pioneered by the Scion XB. Since then, there have been a few other competitors, such as Nissan's Cube and, of course, the Kia Soul. Obviously, there are other vehicles that fit the bill of the mainstream economy class, but none quite have the uniqueness of these three. Each have their own special flavor that makes them different from the others. And while they may not be for everyone, for those who want to go for something a little bit off mainstream, they provide a great blend of practicality and economy, especially with the soul. You can have all of it without sacrificing technology and conventional style with a little bit of a twist. It's by far the most sporty designed out of the three, with its raked windshield, flared fenders, sharp lines, and high gloss black inserts. There's also a great deal of customization options available to make the soul truly stand out. The top trim soul comes with this unique set of 18-inch polished aluminum alloy wheels with high gloss black inserts wrapped in 235/45 all-season tires. Brakes consist of internally ventilated discs in front and solid discs in the rear that bring it to a stop from 60 miles an hour at around 128 feet. As far as the suspension, it consists of independent McPherson struts in front, while the rear is a semi-independent torsion beam. The Kia Soul's chassis begins life based on the Kia Rio, but has been heavily modified to make it more fun to drive and make it feel lively around the corners versus its economy brethren. We'll talk about it a little bit more in depth during the test drive portion, but while it's no razor-sharp sports car, it's very well composed for what it is, making it probably one of the most entertaining choices in the class. One of my favorite design aspects of the Soul personally is the rear end. The first thing you notice about the 2013, like I mentioned, are the new bright LED tail lamps. You also have some high gloss black inserts coming across the lower clip to give it a little bit more of a contrast hue. And this goes to the class as a whole, but thanks to the whole wagon body style philosophy, you're able to buy a smaller vehicle that's more practical than a larger one, but still be able to fit taller and more items into the back, especially if you fold down the rear seat. And your backup camera is located right in the middle of the rear deck. Overall length is 161.6 inches with a width of 70.3 inches and a height of 63.4 inches. Total curb weight is just around 2,800 pounds.
Go ahead and pop the hood.
While the base Soul comes with a 1.6-liter 4-cylinder, upper trim levels get an upgraded 2-liter dual-lever head cam 16-valve 4-cylinder with variable intake valve timing. It produces 164 horsepower at 6,500 RPM and 148 pound-feet of torque at 4,800 RPM. 0 to 60 times are around 8.3 seconds with a quarter-mile time reported as 16.3 seconds at 85 miles an hour. And as far as fuel economy, with a 12.7 gallon tank running on regular gas, expect a miles to a gallon rating of 24 city, 30 highway. The unique and sporty exterior blends into an equally unique interior with plenty of rich details for the class to give it a little bit of a styling edge. Along with a generous amount of standard and optional features, you can load it up with just about all of today's modern tech goodies. Also for this price point, build quality is quite good. All of the panels have nice, tight fitment with a little bit of soft touch material on some of the door handles and middle door inserts. Overall, the two-tone color scheme, especially with some of the other colors available, give it the appearance of being a lot more expensive than it really is. Also new for 2013, like I mentioned, are the power folding mirrors. The seats are fully manual with manual height adjustment for the driver's side, and in the two-tone color scheme vehicles, you also have some color accent stitching on the black portions. The seats are firm with just a moderate amount of padding and some reasonable bolstering up across the sides. You also have adjustable seat belts and headrests with side airbags and the Soul logo embroidered into the back of the seat. Down below you have unique door entry guards with logoed floor mats, as well as a full manual telescoping steering wheel. Like I mentioned earlier, you also have a revised interior lighting system that allows for mood lighting that'll automatically cycle, or music lighting that'll actually dance to the music on the radio.
So let's go ahead and see how she sounds.
And shut her up. Nice and tight panels.
Now we'll go ahead and get a quick acceleration pass. As far as the suspension, it's not too soft where you have any excess body roll or anything like that. It's something you definitely don't want to have in more of a box vehicle. So it's a little bit more on the stiffer side. One good thing about that is that it handles pretty well for what it is. The only other thing is that you'll feel a little bit more of the bumps on some of the more rough roads. Put it in manual mode. It's pretty responsive too. Another thing you'll notice too is, in my opinion, the sole looks a lot more expensive than it is. With the way the design is, way the speakers are placed, how the leather on the steering wheel feels, with all of the available technology and stuff. And that's also nice. This particular vehicle stickers around $23,000 or so. And in my opinion, it's a pretty good bargain for what you get. In driving this a week, I've been pretty comfortable. It's been fairly cold in North Carolina, so I've been using the heated seats and stuff, and with the Infinity audio system and stuff, I mean, it's a nice vehicle for traveling. Now this particular Soul comes with the optional Infinity Premium Audio System with in-dash LCD Mobile Media Navigation Telemetrics Interface, as well as standard Sirius Satellite Radio. Side curtain airbags. Microphone for your hands-free Bluetooth telephone. Card holder, auto-dimming rear view mirror, as well as your interior illumination. Up top, you also have controls for your fully automatic sunroof. Like I said, the interior is very sport-oriented and quite unique. You have all the infotainment and climate control data up here, and up top, three oriented speakers placed around high-gloss surrounds. As far as the radio system, it's quite easy to use. This is your main radio screen. You have your presets located all around, seek and tune, change the different band, scan, as well as your audio adjustments, different equalizer settings. Up top are all of your system functions, phone, map, destination, route, as well as system setup. If you go to phone, it'll bring up the phone screen. With your integrated dialing pad, you can store contacts, voice dial, with the Bluetooth enabled device. Navigation, nice and easy to see. Your destination screen, it's pretty quick too. There's not a whole lot of lag with the system at all. Points of interest, storing addresses, route data, and system setup. Different personalizable options. The navigation system also features real-time traffic updates that you can set up through the map. If you come down the flowing center console, you'll find your different radio modes. Seek, track, AM, FM, satellite radio, as well as your different media options, whether it be hands-free Bluetooth streaming of audio, auxiliary, iPod, USB integration. If you have an iPod, Kia actually supplies this little integrated iPod cable. It'll actually charge it also via this little USB port down below here. So all of your separate ports are located down below with two 12-volt power outlets. And down below, your climate control. Different modes. It'll also show up top. One-touch automatic. You can bring up the climate data to show the pattern of airflow throughout the vehicle. AC, recycling, front and rear defrost, as well as the temperature. Coming across the center console, you have two-stage heated seats for both the driver and passenger. Your handbrake, two cup holders, and a modest center console. As far as your trip computer and little driver information system in the bottom of the speedometer cluster, it's located off to the right. Just press it and you can cycle through the different options. Fuel mileage, trip, and range. Intermittent wipers, your lighting and turn signals. And as far as the multifunction steering wheel, down below are your voice commands.
Command, please.
Help.
To see a list of device-dependent commands, say the device name and help. For example, destination help. They are available at any time during the dialogue.
Alright, your hands-free Bluetooth telephone, cruise control, as well as your different radio controls. Now, I mentioned earlier that the lighting system actually got revised for 2013, so you can change it to mood, music, or just turn it off. You can also change the different colors if you're in music mode and change the brightness down below here. So right now, I have it at the mood lighting setting. It'll just cycle through the different colors of the spectrum. Anyway, such a neat little feature to me. And we'll go ahead and shut her down. And we'll check out the back seat. With its taller height, rear seat room is also quite good. Easy to get in and out. Same two-tone color scheme coming across the rear doors. The back seats will also fold down for a bit of increased storage space. Leg room with a comfortable seating position for myself up front, probably about 3.5-4 inches. Headspace. Being that the sunroof takes up this room here, it actually gets a lot bigger here. So I'd probably say at least 5, maybe 6 inches, kind of a guesstimate. Side curtain airbags for the rear passengers, little quarter windows for better visibility, and coat hugs. And we're going to check out the rest of the vehicle, shall we? As far as rear storage, with all the seats in place, you have around 19.3 cubic feet of storage space. When you put the seats down, it's around 53.4 cubic feet, so it expands quite a bit. The rear is illuminated with a rear-mounted subwoofer for the premium audio system and a bunch of storage space down below. The passenger seat is also manual, but lacks the height adjustment of the driver's seat. It's also got a massive glove box. Two-tier. Put the key fob in there to charge up the battery. Overall, the Kia Soul is a nice blend of modern design elements and features, all at a value price point. Great for those who are on a budget or just wanting to stand out from the pack.